Hello, youngies, and welcome to my channel. My name is Ksenia, and today I'll guide you through the advanced yin yoga session. This is intensive yin yoga class. We are going to improve flexibility with this. You need today two blocks, and nice if you have bolster or any cushion to put under your back when we are going to hold saddle position. So if you're not ready yet for intensive yin yoga stretches, and maybe you feel that it's painful, remember, in yin yoga class we still always want to implement the approach of surrendering, so it's never ever about the pain. So feel free to close the pose earlier or to make more mild modification of this pose. I'm not going to explain much about the poses also because I consider that it's advanced yin yoga class and you're familiar with these poses. So without saying that, let's go deeper into the yin yoga poses. And we are going to start today from the wrist and feet stretches. So from the tabletop position, you want to turn fingers on you, stick with the wrist to the ground, and then tag in your toes, bringing yourself with the sitting bones as low as you can on the heels. Maybe some on the way. Keeping your arms straight and pressing down a little bit, giving like this really nice sticking feeling to the wrists and relaxing. Great, let's start to relieve the pose. You may turn around for a moment. Your wrists are given vice versa pressure. Keep an arm straight. Just a couple of breaths to recover blood circulation. And then we are moving to the melting heart pose. And today I'm going to hold with the blocks this pose. So if you want more intensity, join my variant today. So you're bringing elbows above the blocks on the distance of your shoulders, And then from the heart, we are starting melt down, keeping our hips on the line of the knees. Staying still. Enjoying the stretch. Now softly straightening the arms, giving the base through the hands, walking back to the tabletop position and moving to our hips, maybe using blocks also for the next pose. So you want to step forward into the low lunge with the right foot between the hands. And if you want more intensity, crawl and move back. So never overloading the front knee. I like to hold the pose with the blocks on the sides when my back is more straight and I let my hips to sink down deeper like this. If it's getting intensive for your hip flexors, then ground your hands. So bring yourself a little bit lower like this. It will help to relieve the tension there and stay in relaxing the zone of the stretch. Hips on. Pressing away through the hands, stepping back accurate to the tabletop position, then changing the side. Left foot between the hands, finding the distance between the feet. And then staying still.
again, coming back first to the tabletop position. Bring pelvis back, stepping back. You may put blocks aside, then tagging the toes, bring yourself into the dangling position. Nice distance of your hips. And we are holding more advanced modification of this pose, so keeping legs straight, grabbing opposite elbows, adding like this a little bit more weight of your body into the stretch, relaxing yourself from the low part of the back till the neck, hanging down. Now we start to bend the knees, relieve in the pose, slowly coming back from the inversion. And moving to the advanced modification of supportive fish pose. So bring yourself with the sitting bones between your heels. We will combine now two poses, saddle pose and fish pose. If you need for this modification, maybe pillow under lower part of the back, so grab it here, maybe it's beneficial for you. Bringing blocks into the T shape. Checking how do you feel sitting between the heels. If it's too intensive for you, then feel free to open your legs and keep in more classical pose. And then space between the shoulder blades goes on the first block. And for more advanced stretch, you're bringing arms, hands above the head. Relaxing the heart zone. And we start to close the pose. Coming back first to the sitting position, giving good support through the hands. Then opening legs. Let blood circulation to run other direction, recovering. Maybe a couple of moves here with your knees on. And we are moving now to the double swan or double pigeon pose. Quite intensive stretch for the hips on. You need maybe a block or any soft pillow under your knees here. So I start from the right leg above. Bring knees and feet in one line. If you feel that there is a too big gap under your right knee, you may always use the block. And just accepting the pose, slowly we are going to melt down into this position. If you feel like immediately bringing yourself more to the front with the hands, or maybe using the block in front of you, given like this the base, you may do it. Staying still.
back to initial position, no rush. Support your hands, helping to open the legs and change the sides. So bringing our shins in one line, knees, feet. If you feel that you need to put something for this side under your knee, you may do it.
Wonderful. Let's relive this intensive pose. Bring ourselves to the tabletop position and move into the next one. Intensive hip opener frog pose. So for the frog pose, you may use also cushion or blocks under your hips, under your belly or chest. Squared alignment, opening knees on the sides, maybe bringing your feet outside of your knee line. And this is the moment where you feel like maybe to place the block under the belly, so no any bad sensation in your low part of the back, please, here. And then decreasing the level, maybe forehead on the hands, or if you feel like to hug the pillow or block in front of you, staying still. You start to close the bows in soft manner, so first feet coming back to the middle line, then really good base through the forearms, hands, giving the weight of your body to your hands and arms, gently closing the knees, bringing ourselves on the sitting bones, moving to the straddle pose or wide leg position. Opening feet any comfortable distance when you feel that you're not bending the knees on. Maybe using block in front of you for your forehead. Lean the body from the hip, belly, chest to the front and rounding the back, staying in this great pose for the hips, for the inner thigh, for the hamstrings. Gently press on the way through the hands, coming back with the back into the straight line with the sitting bones. Supportive hands under your knees. Closing the pose. And before Shavasana, our last pose for today, snail or plow pose. So you're bringing yourself all the way down with the back. And if you want to do full modification of this pose, you will bring knees to the chest, straightening the legs, bringing them maybe on the way to the ground, maybe touching the ground. And really up to you here. Maybe you want to bend the knees, so keeping it more in relaxed mode. Maybe support your hands and keeping your legs still in the air. Staying here a shorter period of time, getting relief for our back. Now bending the knees really slow, using your hands like a base, coming back bone after bone, your spine, lower, grounding your low part of the back, pelvis, and then completely relaxing in Shavasana. Quiet mind, quiet body.
slowly awakening. Start to move, doing some soft stretches. Maybe great stretch above the head. Bring yourself on any comfortable side for you. Coming back to the sitting position without any rush. And let's bring our hands in front of the heart for clear and loving intentions. Thank you for joining. Namaste.